What does it mean for you to be an award ceremony voted for, particularly by West End audiences?
It means a huge amount because after having been in the show in New York and being involved with all the amazing hype over there, we've been open now since March, so we didn't really know if the audiences obviously they've kept us open this long, so to now to kind of have this kind of justification that audiences are enjoying our show is really lovely. And to finally feel part of the kind of London theatre, because it's been, I haven't actually met anyone from any other shows, so the most exciting part from today is to actually get to meet other people in other shows. So I'm really excited about that part. But it will be wonderful if we are nominated for anything, but if not, also it's just lovely afternoon to kind of get to know new people.
Of course, An American in Paris in its various forms is one of the most timeless and beloved musical stories. Why do you think that is? What is it emotionally at the core of the story that you think connects with an audience so much?
I think timeless is the thing, really. Romance is always alive. It's such a great film, but our musical is set kind of 10 years earlier than the film was made. So just after the war, when everyone is looking for hope and light at the end of a really dark time. And unfortunately, that is happening in the world right now and probably will continue to happen, unfortunately. So to know that love can come from something terrible is always going to be relevant. So I think that's what makes it pretty timeless.
I think obviously it's a production that has such beautiful elements, particularly a very strong ballet component. Can you talk a little bit about why you think we've seen such a strong revival of, I guess, the traditional musical, particularly here in the West End?
It's actually really exciting. I got to see 42nd Street a couple of weeks ago, and God, it's just the dance in that show is so spectacular, and it's really exciting to see dance be an equal to singing and acting. And I think for a while, not just here in the West End, but over in Broadway, dance was never considered an equal. And I think with shows like American in Paris, like 42nd Street, it becomes an equal, it becomes the storyteller. It's not just 5, 6, 7, 8 and a dance break. The story keeps on going through the dance, which I think has kind of pushed musical theatre into new boundaries, really, because before, the dance really wasn't telling the story, but because of shows like ours and because of directors like Christopher Wheeldon, that has now become an equal part to the singing and the acting.
Final question, if people do want to come and see you, where can they go for information about the production and tickets and all that wonderful stuff?
We are at the Dominion Theatre, which is on Tottenham Court Road, and we have a box office, and you can also look at us online. We have a Twitter handle, which is at An American in Paris. All those things. You can see us on Facebook and Twitter and Instagram, but obviously the box office is at the Dominion Theatre.